Every 4 to 6 weeks, I compile a list of the 8 best quantum stocks, in my opinion, that you can buy. These are the 8 must-have quantum stocks in your portfolio, ranked from 1 to 8, and the rankings change every month. I keep a historical data on this, and this just changes based on sector momentum, news, earnings, roadmaps, all kinds of different things. Since this space is constantly changing, the ranks also change, and we do have a new number one today. I'm not gonna give that away, but we're gonna cover 8 stocks today. We're gonna cover the Quantum 8, the 8 quantum stocks to supercharge your growth portfolio, and we're gonna do this as efficiently as possible. Before we jump in, I do have a special announcement today. As you guys know, I work very hard to produce quality content for you all here on YouTube and on my website, thequantumbull.com. Today, I'm announcing channel memberships on YouTube, so if you would like to support my website or YouTube channel, I encourage you to go and check those out. The channel memberships are as follows. So there's the Quantum Bull, which is $4.99 a month, and it helps support me and my efforts here on YouTube and running thequantumbull.com. You also get occasional member-only videos and member-only polls. Then there's the Golden Bull, which includes trade alerts like my buys and sells and private Discord access, and that's $14.99 a month. And then there's Diamond Bull, which this one is more exclusive, and I will do a one-on-one video call with you every quarter. We'll have a direct private chat, and I'm gonna deliver to you a 4K nature photography bundle. So if you'd like to support the channel, I would love to have you as a member. I'm excited to get the Discord started. And for the first 25 members, I'm gonna just get you guys a shirt, okay? Something like this. I don't really care if it's gonna cost me a little bit of extra money. For the founders, for the founding members, the first 25 members that sign up, I don't care whether you sign up for the Quantum Bull or the Golden Bull, whatever, you're getting a shirt. You're getting a damn shirt, okay? First 25 members. So, all right, so let's jump into the Quantum 8. So if you head over to thequantumbull.com, you'll notice right away you have 4 options. You can click Dream, Learn, News, Invest. We're gonna go right to Invest because this is the home of the Quantum 8. All right, at number 8 is Honeywell. And Honeywell is an interesting company because this is kind of a proxy play for a private company called Continuum. I recently did some coverage on Continuum inside Quantum, and I was really impressed with Continuum, their CEO, their roadmap, and just what they're doing in the private space around quantum computing. So by investing in Honeywell, by proxy, you're investing in Continuum. So Continuum has a rough valuation of about $5 billion right now, and they do plan to IPO. I think they would be worth more than $5 billion if they IPO'd. So that's why Honeywell has bumped Microsoft off the Quantum 8. So this is a little bit of an older article about Continuum, but Honeywell Brass expects Continuum to pull in $2 billion worth of sales within 4 years. And Continuum, I think by 2029, they want a fully fault tolerant quantum computer. Could be wrong on that. I know that IBM has recently moved up their roadmap. Anyway, I did full coverage on this. I'm going to put the thumbnail on the screen. Go check out that video if you want to learn about Psi Quantum and Continuum. That video wasn't very popular on my channel, but I think it's important to stay up to date on what the private companies are doing as well, because a lot of them are very strong in this race. At number 7 is Amazon. So Amazon, we know, has their Ocelot quantum computing chip. Amazon Web Services announced in February of 2025 that they have a quantum computing chip that can reduce the cost of implementing quantum error correction by up to 90% compared to current approaches. They use something called a cat qubit, which builds error correction in from the ground up. Cat qubits are named after the famous Schrodinger's cat thought experiment and intrinsically suppress certain forms of errors. So Amazon Ocelot with their cat qubits, an interesting proxy play. Now the thing with Amazon is when you buy Amazon, you're obviously not just investing in quantum, you're investing in all their other pillars of business. And to me right now, I get the feeling that quantum is a very, very small kind of a moonshot part of their whole operation. So Amazon Ocelot at number 7. At number 6, moving down one rank, Google and Google Willow. So I did scour the internet and look for basically updates since we got Google Willow's first announcement in December of 2024. And that's what started this whole craze with quantum stocks and sent all of the quantum stocks up higher just to be sent down in January. So Google Willow was first announced in December 9th of 2024. However, they came into this blog article last month in June 12th, 2025 and provided some update. So this blog post now says it's last updated on June 12th, 2025. I would rather see a new blog post personally than to just see them edit an old blog post. I don't think there's a lot that's happened since they first announced, but Google does seem to be a very strong player as far as the tech titans in quantum specifically. I think their program is what started all of this off. And let's take a look. I did highlight. So Willow's performance on this benchmark is astonishing. It performed a computation in under 5 minutes that would take one of today's fastest supercomputers 10 septillion years, or this many years. So that's the power of a quantum computer, the potential power of a quantum computer. The challenge for all of these companies is getting them to be able to use them on useful problems. And that's, I believe, the current criticism of Google is that it's very powerful, but at this point it can't be used on a useful problem. All right, at number 5, moving up 2 spots is LAES, CLSQ. I know a lot of you who follow this channel are big fans of this very small company. And what I wrote here in the rank notes is if you're looking to take a chance on a possible near-term growth story, LAES has decent catalysts, including attractive price point, recent acquisitions, and potential expansion into the US. Quantum cybersecurity is an emerging theme. So let's take a look at their website and what they're doing. So recently they launched satellite with SpaceX, and they've done this before. So they're partners with SpaceX and Elon Musk's company. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to get space-based cybersecurity and decentralized infrastructure, marking the first satellite to embed SealSQ's quantum root key. They have a host of different products and services, including their custom chips. I talked to a super investor in this company, a guy who now has 30,000 shares. If you want to learn more about SealSQ, check out that video. And they're building quantum resistant products and services, and they're talking about the quantum threat. So what is the quantum threat? Quantum computers are machines that use the property of quantum physics to store data and perform computations. This can be extremely advantageous for certain tasks where they could vastly outperform our supercomputers. One task could be to crack our current RSA encryption. And that's the whole thing with CLSQ, is they believe this is gonna happen, and they're building chips and software and products and solutions to get ahead of the quantum threat. And it's also known as Q-Day. At number 4, jumping one spot, none other than Rigetti Spaghetti. So Rigetti, the reason I moved Rigetti up, I'll take a look at the rank notes here. They recently completed their at-the-market offering. They've improved their cash position. They have this really strong Quanta partnership. And we cannot underestimate the Quanta partnership. Quanta made early bets on NVIDIA and Apple and still works with NVIDIA and Apple. Also, given the price target from Cantor Fitzgerald and the initiated coverage from Wall Street, I'm more bullish on Rigetti than last time I did this. So they did their $350 million at-the-market equity offering. With this additional funding, Rigetti will have approximately $575 million of cash, cash equivalents, and available for sale investments with no debt, and is well positioned to support commercial scale-up of its superconducting gate-based quantum computers. They don't have as many expenses either as other quantum companies, so their cash position is very attractive. I'm gonna put a thumbnail up on the screen. I did cover this, and that $500-ish million they have should give them lots of runway to get to commercial advantage. Just a little bit more detail on the Quanta partnership. Rigetti and Quanta have committed to investing $250 million each over the next 5 years. So that $35 million that they already got this year from Quanta for the next 5 years, another $35 million, $35 million, $35 million. So that's gonna help the share price, and that's gonna help Rigetti refine and make better quantum products. At number three is IBM. And IBM, as far as bigger companies goes, is honestly a freak beast. IBM and RIKEN just unveiled Japan's first IBM Quantum System 2. And IBM also has plans to deliver a first large-scale fault-tolerant quantum computer with 200 logical qubits by 2029, or halfway through 2025. That's 3.5 years, 4 years from now, where we're gonna be seeing from IBM a large-scale fault-tolerant quantum computer. Not 15 or 20 years, 3 or 4 years. Pretty impressive also how they've accelerated their timeline. So this is the IBM and RIKEN story. The future of computing is quantum-centric, and with our partners at RIKEN, we are taking a big step forward to this vision as a reality. The new IBM Quantum System 2, powered by our latest Heron processor and connected to Fugaku, will allow scientists and engineers to push the limits of what is possible. So by 2029, IBM wants to deliver Quantum Starling, which will be built in IBM's new quantum data center in New York, and is expecting to perform 20,000 times more operation than today's quantum computers. I think the economic value from a computer that powerful is going to start to become more and more evident over these next couple of years. They won't just suddenly be 20,000 times more powerful. There's going to be iterations until then, and we're going to start to see the possibilities. IBM is charting the next frontier in quantum computing. Our expertise across math, physics, engineering is paving the way for large-scale fault-tolerant quantum computers, one that will solve real-world challenges and unlock immense possibilities for business. So IBM holds rank three. Dropping to rank two is DWave. So DWave Quantum held number one for the last 2 months. DWave Quantum drops to number two with a recent lull in news as early 2025 momentum appears to be waning, at least for now. In the story of DWave Quantum, they have released a big paper basically announcing quantum supremacy on a real-world problem. Their stock price is 4x, 3x or 4x from the start of the year. They beat on earnings. They made a system sale to Jülich, Germany. They've installed their computers in other places such as Alabama and South Korea. So the question isn't if D-Wave is going to continue to be successful and give us amazing news, it's just when. And there's been a lull. However, they did just complete $400 million at the market equity offering, which puts them in a cash position of over $800 million. I'm going to put the thumbnail on the screen because I covered this in depth. But what this means for a company like this is 2 quarters ago, they were operating with around $50 million of cash. Now they have a war chest of $800+ million. This is a huge, huge, huge increase for them to do acquisitions, to hire, to do research, to accelerate their gate-based machines. I think the story is just getting started with D-Wave Quantum. And the thing is, D-Wave isn't a startup. D-Wave has been around for decades. You can go back and look yourself. D-Wave's been posting news to their site all the way back to 2018. We can go back and look at that. D-Wave's been around and they have tons of potential. They also had their announcement of the Advantage 2 quantum computer, and they call it their most advanced and performant system. So that is now widely available, and anyone can request to buy one. So that's also a very good sign. We also saw recently that D-Wave and Yonsei University in South Korea have a strategic relationship. So that the Advantage 2 system is now there, and the university and the mayor over there are delighted to have this quantum system for their research purposes as they want to move South Korea into this new technological frontier. So moving up to number one is IonQ. And IonQ jumps to number one based on major acquisitions, including Oxford Ionics, LightSync. In addition to these acquisitions, they have accelerated their quantum roadmap and quantum timeline. I've gone into their first quarter financial results, and I just wanted to share a few things. So we can see that a lot of these quantum companies are building up a big cash position so they can weather storms. Right now, they have cash and cash equivalents of $700 million. We look forward to adding a unique accelerant to both our quantum networking and quantum computing roadmaps. So this is the thing about IonQ and what you get with IonQ that you maybe don't get with the other pure plays. They're also doing quantum networking, which will also be a big deal. LightSync's unique quantum memory technology, intellectual property, and Harvard research pedigree is expected to accelerate IonQ's commercial system to tens of thousands and someday millions of qubits. In addition, we expect that LightSync's quantum memory will also power the future quantum internet by allowing repeaters to ultimately be spaced over 100 kilometers apart. IonQ is speeding up drug development with partners like AstraZeneca, Amazon Web Services, and NVIDIA. This happened just less than a month ago, where they announced that IonQ designed a workflow, provided an end-to-end example of hybrid quantum classical that helped provide solutions to complex pharmaceutical development challenges and has the potential to improve speed and efficiency within the drug development process. This is one of the most exciting things about quantum computing, is those very, very difficult drug discovery problems. We may be able to throw a whole lot more compute power at them, and using the synthetic data and different types of approaches, we can develop new and novel drugs and novel approaches. IonQ announced their agreement to acquire Oxford Ionics, accelerating a path towards breakthroughs in quantum computing. The transaction will bring together IonQ's quantum compute application and networking stack with Oxford Ionics' groundbreaking ion trap technology manufactured on standard semiconductor chips. The combined technologies are expected to deliver innovative, reliable quantum computers that increase in power, scale, and problem solving. They expect to build systems with 256 physical qubits at accuracies of 99.99% by 2026. And advance to over 10,000 physical qubits with logical accuracies of 99.99999% by 2027. This is a couple years away. IonQ, and I maintain my price target of IonQ of $100 a share by the end of the year. They also had their acquisition of LightSync, and this deal accelerates the shift from experimental bulk optics to scalable optical chips, moving us closer to commercializing our next generation of advanced quantum technologies on the quantum internet. IonQ, of all the quantum players, has put up some decent revenues. They're still burning cash, they're still not profitable, but some things are heading the right direction. We see that revenue's been a little bit lumpy, but we can see the overall trend is they're making money from building quantum and quantum partnerships. We can see that operating cash flow is moving in the right direction. Free cash flow, while negative, is moving in the right direction. We can see they're building up their cash and cash equivalents. And according to them, this bar should be more like this, about $700 million, which puts them in a secure position to continue to build out the quantum internet and their quantum computers. Took a lot of research and a lot of thinking and a lot of time. I'm always a little bit afraid because I think some people might get mad or something, but at the end of the day, I'm not really biased. You can go back and look at the historical Quantum 8 rankings, which I list right below the chart. Anyway, just a reminder, I'm launching memberships literally today. So the first 25 members who are founding members will get some sort of swag like this. And I really appreciate you all watching, and I appreciate the channel growing, and we'll talk to you all soon.